Now, I'm not one to gossip, but I will bring you the tea. Welcome to Chronicle Speaks.
Please, please, I don't have any time for any gossip now. Eh? Yes.
Now, I don't know about y'all, but I love to see situations when a woman is coming out of a divorce triumphant. You know, one of those divorces that looks like it would have kept you down or even killed you. And then the woman looks back at herself like, you know what? I made it and I'm stronger now. That's exactly what I see when I see Mary J. Blige. Sis is looking like fine wine. She's getting better with time, and I can definitely appreciate that about her. Now, she recently did an interview with Self Magazine, and she spoke about recovery, healing, and taking care of herself. In this same interview, she also gave us some insight on how she got over that crazy ex-husband of hers, Kendu. Now, Mary J. Blige has been a shero when it comes to who do you listen to when you're going through a breakup. She gave us anthems like Just Fine, Take Me As I Am, No More Drama, Child, the list goes on. Now, Mary J. Blige met her now ex-husband, Martin Kendu Issacs, in the year 2000. And let me tell you something about him. Although he's not famous because of the type of work he's done, he's been linked to the likes of Nia Long, Queen Latifah, Lauryn Hill, and Kimora Lee Simmons before. Child, if that ain't the most random list of women, but I'll go ahead and move on. Either way, these two met in the year 2000 and they began dating. Now, they knew that they were meant for each other and they tied the knot 3 years later. Kendu was just off the heels of a divorce and was bringing 3 kids to the relationship. Although Mary didn't mind, she was happy to be in love. Now, a lot of people were afraid that her music was gonna change because we're used to her singing about the men that have done her wrong and her way of getting out of it. Surprising enough to Mary J. Blige, she thought she had this marriage thing figured out to a science. In 2014, she told a British magazine, "All females for me, all guys for him. There's none of that. Oh, that's my female friend. Oh, that's my guy friend. No, not in a marriage. I've never seen that work." A lot of people were like, what is she gonna sing about now? Not even knowing that things wouldn't remain happy for the couple forever. After 12 years of marriage, things ended. Now, like many of us, when you're in a relationship, all things look good and smell beautiful. Now, when Mary was with Kendu, she attributed her husband as the reason why she left drugs and alcohol alone. But not anymore. In a recent interview that Mary did with Self Magazine, she says, "When I look back, I see that we all want what we want, and we want it to be the way that we want it to be. I wanted a savior. I've been hurting so much and so long and so bad." Now, as for her husband's role in breaking her drug habit, she now admits he did not deserve that credit. She says that she put her ex in the driver's seat, not because he was equipped to handle it, but because she wanted the fairy tale to be real. Child, I felt that last sentence right there. Now, she says the reality is that in order to break the chains of addiction, she had to address the demons within that she was attempting to quiet by getting high and drunk, and face the pain that came with losing them as a crutch. She says we numb ourselves with drugs and alcohol and people and shopping and shit to cover up what's really going on inside. You're taking drugs so you can go out and feel courageous or go out and feel beautiful or whatever. You're doing it to cover up something. She says that once it became apparent to her what her future held if she didn't get better, she found the strength she needed to push forward. She said, "I've seen visions of what I would look like if I kept doing drugs." She says, added that there were also some nights when her reality may have mirrored those perhaps prophetic visualizations closely. "If I saw myself almost dying, or if I almost died or almost OD'd, why would I do that again?" Now, all in all, Mary is not wanting to give credit to Kendu, and I'ma tell you like this, I can't blame her. We're gonna get into him and his doggish ways in a minute. So let me first tell you about an episode of The Real from yesterday. Tisha Campbell has been guest hosting all week, and they talked about Mary J. Blige's article with Self Magazine. Now, if you didn't know, Tisha Campbell was going through a messy divorce with her ex-husband, Dwayne Martin, as well, and she just recently moved out of the family home. Now, this home that she lived in was 13,000 square feet, but she said she left all her belongings in there, expensive furniture. She just wanted to get out because there was no love there. Sis just wasn't happy. Take a look at her Instagram video, and then I'll be back with more.
"Yo, one time this person asked me, 'This house is beautiful. What more could you want?' And I said, 'Happiness. I'm free. I don't live here no more. I'm free, y'all. I'm so happy.' Wow.
Now, on this episode of The Real, Tisha Campbell said that she admired Mary J. Blige, and Mary J. Blige actually helped her get through her divorce. Now, another person that wanted to talk about their divorce is Jeannie Mai. She admitted that she as well gave her ex credit that he did not deserve. Take a listen to this.
Just in my situation, I can only speak from my experience. I never grew up with Cinderella syndrome because I knew those white girls ones in my story, honestly. And I even didn't want to be married, okay? So I think if you look back at seasons where I gave a lot of credit, it was because my own standards were low. And that is just we can go into a whole counseling session as to why I only gave myself that bare minimum. So I'm not blaming my ex for the things that he barely came through to do. I was just like, when you say, oh, good for you, you did that documentary, or that's cool, then I'm like, great, he supports me, awesome. That to me is now my standard of support. I didn't know for two things. I didn't know until, honestly, my new relationship that even something as basic as, oh my God, I'm not crying to feel bad for me. I'm just like, it was so touchy.
It's okay, it's okay.
But like even something as basic as like at his birthday party, he left to go, like left his birthday party to drive me to the airport to Atlanta. And I was like, yo, I can Uber. Like I Uber my whole life. I've Ubered through my marriage. I'm good. And he was looking at me like, are you crazy? Like I need to see you off. I'm to drive you to the airport. That to me was, so I'm just saying, you can blame or you can say or not blame, but just be mindful of your standard. And sometimes for me, being alone in that time that I took to myself was my upgrade. That was your own upgrade.
So it looks like Mary wasn't the only one giving credit to her mate, as opposed to knowing that women are capable of upgrading and improving themselves. Now, one of the reasons why Mary J. Blige probably wasn't ready to give Kendu any praise, it's hard to think that a man that you once loved and gave your all to for so long could drag you through the mud and trenches. Now, during the relationship, there were so many accusations made. For one, there was a woman named Starshell, who was once a part of Mary's record label and rumored to be the chick that Kendu was seeing and allegedly spent over $420,000 on. Now, whose money do you think that was? Right, Mary's. Now, some reports say that Kendu said that Mary was cheating on him with Starshell, but I don't believe that crap. Child, it was just all a mess. Now, after Mary filed for divorce from Isaacs, he requested that she pay over $100,000 a month in spousal support, as opposed to the $30,000 that he was receiving every month. Child, this fool wanted $5,000 to support his parents, $4,971 to support his two children from a previous relationship, $1,200 a month to go out to eat, $2,500 a month on auto expenses and transportation, $5,708 for a housekeeper and maintenance on his properties, $1,724 in groceries, and $5,000 a month to tithes and offerings. Child, he wanted her to give him money to pay to the Lord, child. Who else's husband does this sound like? That doggone Kelvin Hunter, Wendy Williams' husband. Now, Mary settled with Kendu for an undisclosed amount. However, this man was going back and forth saying that she had messed up his name in the industry and he was unable to get work. He had trashed a home that they were renting together. Things were just crazy. Either way, sis has moved on and it seems like her blessings are running over and she deserves nothing less. It was recently announced that she's going to be on a spinoff of the show Power called Power Book 2, and she recently just finished the royalty tour with Nas that was very successful. It looks like Mary is definitely blessed and highly favored, and I'm glad she found out they can't know can do, won't do, can't do, or ain't gonna do is going to hold her back no matter how much he asks for. Now, what I need you guys to do is leave a comment. Tell me what you think about Mary J. Blige saying that her ex does not need any credit, honey, because he definitely doesn't, at least in my opinion. Leave a comment. Tell me what you think about this article, which I'm going to leave a link to in the description box. And you know how we do. We'll talk about it down below. Talk to you guys later. Bye. All right, in this video, I want to tell you about a company called Ash Kickin'. Now, you know your girl Chronicles would not promote a company without doing one of those thorough Chronicle Speaks investigations, honey. And Ash Kickin' definitely passed the test. Y'all make sure to check out ashkickin.com for one of the best 100% natural home fragrance and beauty products, honey. And use my code Chronicles at checkout for an extra 15% off just for you.
And before you go, don't forget to hit the bell for notifications, like this video, and subscribe. And we'll talk to you guys later. Bye.